Every other Thursday, we're taking a look at a health issue or concern affecting many people. We're breaking down the information for you and telling you what you need to know to keep you healthy. In today's Ask a Doctor segment, Dr. Kalani Brady from the John A. Burns School of Medicine joins us with more on coronavirus symptoms. Good morning, Dr. Brady.
Good morning.
Okay, so I know there have been a lot of different symptoms that were initially announced that we should be looking out for, but recently there were also more symptoms added to look out for COVID-19. So what is the overview of the symptoms? What should you be looking out for?
In general, most of the symptoms are the same as those of a cold or flu. It starts out with sore throat, runny nose, congestion, headaches, cough, shortness of breath, fever, usually low grade, but it can be a high fever as well. There are some additional symptoms in addition to the muscle aches that come with that. One of them is a loss of taste or smell, and then nausea or vomiting and diarrhea, which are not common with a cold.
And when it comes to, if someone is feeling these symptoms, differentiating between knowing if they have a cold, the flu, or the coronavirus, you really don't know until you get tested, correct?
Right. You would talk about the problem with your doctor. Your doctor may have you come in or may order a coronavirus test, a COVID-19 PCR test, which can be done in a number of places around the city and around the state.
And what does that test entail? Because I've heard it can be pretty uncomfortable.
My wife had the test yesterday, and they stuck the tube down her nose all the way to the back. And she said it wasn't uncomfortable at all. So it isn't always uncomfortable, but basically it involves taking a swab, inserting it into the nose, and pushing it a far distance back and twirling it and bringing it out. And almost always it causes a cough or sneeze response, which is why the person who's getting the test needs to be in personal protective equipment, mask, visor, the dress that's important, and gloves.
Okay, and wow, your wife is a trooper, because I've heard, well, of course, different responses. I'm sure a lot of it's mental too, right? You have to go into it knowing what's going to be happening, but also I hope she's okay. Keep us posted.
Right.
Okay, and when it comes to, you know, when it comes to actually getting the test, because not everyone is necessarily approved for them, how do you get the, I guess, approval to get the test done? Who should you be contacting?
You contact your doctor.
Your doctor.
And if they don't authorize the test, if they're not in that business, then they will refer you to a doctor that does authorize the test.
Okay.
HPH, Hawaii Pacific Health, and Queens, among other places, have doctors that do it over the phone. And so it's an easy process to be authorized for the test.
And for that phone call, I have heard, I have a friend that called not feeling well, and they had some mild symptoms. And again, as we were saying, a lot of them similar to a cold, like runny nose, a cough. But they said they weren't approved for the test, but they said to self-isolate just in case. What do you say to something like that? Should you still be treating it as coronavirus, even if they said you don't qualify for a COVID test?
You should basically be self-isolating until the symptoms of the cold completely resolve. The coronavirus symptoms generally occur between 2 and 14 days after exposure. And Kelly, the most important thing to know here is that frequently you may have no symptoms at all.
Right.
And so caution is really important to avoid transmission of this virus. Use of a mask, 6-foot distancing, use of frequent hand washing, use of hand sanitizers, alcohol-based, and staying at home as much as possible. We can't forego those protections. And you notice that our numbers are higher, and you notice the filming shows people without masks almost everywhere. Masks are very important in the protection against transmission.
Okay, and of course we've been going over during the segment all of the different symptoms, the overview of the symptoms, but a lot of times when folks have the coronavirus, they can be asymptomatic, not showing any of these. So that's why it's important to always treat yourself as if you have the virus and not wanting to spread it. So make sure you're still self-isolating, social distancing, and of course, always wearing your mask.
Right.
All right. Thanks so much, Dr. Brady, for joining us this morning.
You're welcome.
All right. And I hope you and your wife are going to be doing well. Wishing you, of course, health as always. Have a great weekend ahead, and we'll talk to you next week.
Thanks. Take care.
Thank you. You too.